वक्रतुंड महाकाय सूर्यकोटि समर्पणं कुरुमे देव सर्वकार्येषु सर्वदा सरस्वती नमस्तुभ्यं वररूपां विद्यारम्भं करिष्यामि सिद्धिर्भवतु मे सदा वागर्थाय संपृक्तौ वागस्थ प्रतिपत्तये जगत् पितरौ वन्दे पार्वती परमेश्वरौ वीणाक्षरसमान्वयमधिगम्य महेश्वरात् कृत्संव्याकरणं प्रोक्तं तस्मै पाणिनये नमः वाक्यकारं वररुचिं भाष्यकारं पतञ्जलिं पाणिनिं सूत्रकारं च प्रणतोऽस्मित्रयम् धातुर्ब्रह्मैव सम्प्रोक्तो जीव आख्यातमुच्यते प्रकृतिकृत्स्वन्ताधिर्धातुब्रह्मात्मने नमः शुक्लां ब्रह्मविचारसारपरमा महत्यां जगद्व्यापिनीं वीणा पुस्तकधारिणीं वेदाञ्जाड्यान्धकारापहां हस्ते स्फाटिकमालिकां विदधतीं पद्मासने संस्थितां वन्दे तां परमेश्वरीं भगवतीं बुद्धिप्रदां शारदाम् तत्वा सरस्वती देवी शुक्तां पुण्यां करोमि पाणिनीय प्रवेशाय लघु सिद्धांत कौमुदी सॉरी सो लेट मी अनप्लग दी इयरफोन सो दैट यू आई कैन यू नो मूव अराउंड टू कफ एंड यू वोंट हैव टू हियर द नॉइस एम आई स्टिल ऑडिबल Could someone confirm if I'm still audible?
Yeah, you're audible. Can you hear me? Yes, audible.
Audible, right? Okay. So, the next Vidhi Sutra is Adar Dataradhibhya Panchabhya. It's a Vidhi Sutra. So, Adad, it's difficult to pronounce. Dakar and Dhatara. Adad Dataradhibhya दिभ्य पंचभ्य नपुंसे नपुंसकेभ्य सोमो सो सु एंड अम अम इज सेकेंड केस सिंगुलर सु एंड अम दिस इज फॉर न्यूटर वी आर लुकिंग एट न्यूटर सो सॉरी डतरा एंड अदर फाइव टाइप्स दीज आर एक्चुअली फाइव बिकॉज पंचभ्य इज मेंशन So, Datara and other four in Napunsaka should be the Pratipadika preceding. So, this is fifth case plural. This is also fifth case plural. And Adid is the Adesha. Dakara, actually Adid, to protect Dakara has been added. So, Dakara is it. It's a dit Adesha. So, Ad will be the content. So, Ad. is the Adesha to Su as well as Am if the Pratipadika is in Napunsaka and one of the five Datara etc. So that is the Sutra. Example is Katara. Katara is Datara one of the five starting from Datara. So Kim plus Datara actually. So Katara, how many Katara, how many is the meaning there? So, Katara plus Su in Napunsaka, what will happen? Su is replaced by Adida, Dakara goes away, so you get Ad. So, Katarad and Katarad further to be continued. So, you are not derived it yet. Then Dakara is an it pratyaya, so it's a dit pratyaya. Dakara is an it letter in the adesha, so it's a dit adesha, not a pratyaya, dit adesha. So diti bhasya tehe, vidhi sutra is tehe. So t, which is the set of letters starting with the last vowel. So tehe, shashti ekvachana, tehe kim bhavati? Diti bhasya lopaha bhavati. Lopa is the adesha, bhasya angasya. Bhasya tehe, diti pratyepare. So adesha is adad. So it has replaced the su or am pratyaya. So although adad is the adesha, it is to the pratyaya. So the adesha will take the place of the pratyaya. This will also be a pratyaya. Adad will retain the pratyaya samya from the su and am. So diti pare. Since it adad is a dit pratyaya, this dakara goes away. So diti pare tehe lopa bhasyangasya. So that which is anga, which is having the sanya bha, that will have t being dropped, lopaha bhavati. So we have derived till what? Katarad. Now katarad, katarad ad is a not katara and not katarad, katara and ad. So if you do a akasavarne dirga, you'll get katarad, but that is not the form. Katarat is the form, therefore this a has to undergo lopa. So katara is pada or bha now. So katara followed by su, su pratyaya swadishu asarvanamasthane padam. But in napunsaka, which is the sarvanamasthana, she sarvanamasthanam, therefore the and just so she. So just and shas meaning first case plural and second case plural. So jas shasoho shi adesha is there, and shi sarvanamasthanam, shi is sarvanamasthanam sthanam, therefore sthanam, therefore these two are sarvanamasthana, which means that su as well as am, all of these are asarvanamasthana. And yachibham yakaradi pratyay pare bha sanya. So here what do we have here? Su adishu asarvanamasthana and ajadi pratyay. Su is replaced by ad, so it is an ajadi pratyay. Now being ajadi pratyay, swadishu swadishu asarnamasthane padam, that pada sanya is no longer there because it is in the ekasanya adhikara. Yachibham yakaradi and ajadi pratyay pare bha sanya. So this fellow will have gotten a bha sanya. Now this is applicable as to tehe bhasya angasya tehe lopaha diti pratyay pare. So when the dit pratyay is following, other is a dit pratyaya, this is got a bha sanya. Samoho here panchabhya tehe bhasya lopa. So you have to add here yachibham to know how bha sanya has come in. Yachibham also, and the shi sarvanamasthanam jasasho shi, all these can be added. Yachibham, then you get this bha sanya for the anga, then bhasya tehe t of this. So t would be what? Kata, he not here. Here, so here ar ara katara, so katara the last letter after repha, this is the t, so that goes away. So you get katar plus ad, so just varna milna will be katarad, and then vavasane jhalam jasha char, jhalam jas char cha. So here you will get charadesha and you will get katarat. So katarat is the form here, katarat, katare, katarani ityadi, and then he katarat shesham pumvat. So everything else is like pum, then evam katamat etc. So katara and then katama, one among two. Katara, katarat is how many among two, and katamat is how many in plural. So thereby katara in napunsaka is over. There is a vartika there as to ekatarat pratishedo vaktavya. Ekatarat pratishedo vaktavya. So ekatarat, the ekatara, not katara but ekatara. There ekatara, for that there should be a pratisheda of this sutra. Thereby vartikara says ekatarat pratishedo vaktavya. Then what will happen? Ekatara plus su. Here adad dataradipya panchabhya has a pratisheda in the vartika, therefore atom comes back and applies. Once atom applies, then su will not be replaced by adad, it will be replaced by am. Then you will get ekataram. Ami purvaha ekaha akaha ekaha purva parayo samhitayam. So ekatara and am, you will get ekataram form. So purva पूर्व अ दिस अ दैट फॉलोज दिस रेफा दिस अ विल रिप्लेस बोथ दिस एंड एज वेल एज दिस अ सो बोथ ऑफ दिस विल बी रिप्लेस बाय द पूर्व ये कहा पूर्व सो दिस पूर्व इज अ एकतर सो देर वोंट बी सवर्ण दीर्घ संधि देर बी एकतरम बाय अमी पूर्व The next word taken into consideration for Napunsaka is Shriyam Pati Iti Shripam, one who protects wealth. Not one here, that which protects wealth, because Napunsaka will say in English that which protects wealth. So Shri plus Am, Pa plus Rakshane, Pa Rakshane plus Quip. Quip is a pratyaya which will give you Shri Pa. Shri Pa is the प्रातिपदिका श्रीपा आकारांत प्रातिपदिका नाउ इन नपुंसक व्हाट विल हैपन विधि सूत्र सेज ह्रस्व नपुंसके प्रातिपदिकस्य सो प्रातिपदिकस्य नपुंसके व्हेन नपुंसक प्रत्यय फॉलोज विभक्ति प्रत्यय फॉलोज देन ह्रस्व आदेश भवति सो श्रीपा आ हियर आ विल टेक अ ह्रस्व आदेश सो इट विल टेक एन अकार आ विल बिकम अकारा सो श्रीपा विल बिकम श्रीप सो श्रीपा हैज बिकम श्रीप नाउ देन आई एम सॉरी देन वंस इट बिकम श्रीप लाइक ज्ञान फल एक्सेट्रा फलम फले फलानी ज्ञानम ज्ञाने ज्ञाने सिमिलरली श्रीपम श्रीपे श्रीपाणी सो दिस इज हाउ द श्रीपा विल डिक्लाइन आकारांत ऑल्सो विल डिक्लाइन लाइक अकारांत After taking Hraswa Adesha by Hraswa Napunsakasya Hraswa Napunsake Pratipadikasya. Now Ikaranta Vari Shabda in neuter. What happens? Vari means Jala. So Vrinj Varane plus Nich plus Inj Pratya. Samunadi Pratya is there. Vasiva Piyaji Ityadi. So Unadi. Unadi Sutras are a little difficult to see. But it's considered as a Krit. उणादिभ्यो बहुलम सो कृत प्रत्यय दिस इट इज लॉट ऑफ थिंग्स कैन हैपन देयरफॉर बहुलम इट इज अ कृत प्रत्यय व्हाई इज कृत इंपॉर्टेंट बिकॉज वारी एज डिराइव्ड विल बिकम अ कृदंत शब्द टेकिंग अ उणादि कृत प्रत्यय एंड देयर व्हाई कृत्तदित समासाश्च कैन अप्लाई एंड वारी विल बिकम अ प्रातिपदिक इन द मीनिंग ऑफ जला सो व्हाट हैपेंस हियर सो वारी नीर अनिटि इत्यादि has caused this pratipedika to be vari. Next, Vidhi Sutra tells, Swamor Napunsakat Luk. So what happens with ikara ending words is that earlier we had seen the Swamor Adada Pratya or the Am. Am is the Adesha in Napunsaka or we see with Hraswa Adesha also. Adada Pratya can apply or Hraswa Adesha for Akara Ityadi. But ikara ending words what happens here is that there is a look these su pratyas samoho su and am pratyas su is first case singular and am is second case singular so both will take look so it will go away nothing will remain therefore the first case singular will be vari itself and second case singular also will be vari but in napunsaka anyway second case and first case forms are same so vari plus su this su goes away and then you get goes away vari what happens with vari plus au shi aungaha so sutra au is replaced by shi napumsaka cha shi aungaha so au pratyaya is replaced by shi shakara is an it letter by lashakva taddite tasya lopaha so e will remain and this although this au has been replaced by shi it is still going to act like au only meaning it is a vibhakti it is a sup स्वादि प्रत्यय सुप प्रत्यय सो शी विल ऑल्सो बी कंसिडर्ड एज अ सुप विभक्ति बाय स्थानीवद आदेशो नल विदौ एंड देयर बाय वारी प्लस ई विल बी स्टिल अ सुबंत पद सो वारी प्लस ई नाउ व्हाट हैपेंस ई कार इज देयर दीर्घ सो वारी प्लस ई वी एक्सपेक्ट अ अकसवर्णे दीर्घ एंड देयर कैन बी वारी काइंड ऑफ अ फॉर्म बट विधि सूत्र नेक्स्ट विधि सूत्र से इको ची विभक्त नपुंसकस्य नुम नुम आदेश सो इको अचि इकह अचि विभक्त अचि विभक्त परे व्हेन एन अजादि अचि विभक्ति विल टेक तदादि विधि देयरफॉर अजादि विभक्त परे व्हेन एन अजादि विभक्ति फॉलोज व्हाट इकह इकह नपुंसकस्य सो अंगा इज नपुंसक देयरफॉर नपुंसकस्य इकह विल टेक तदंत विधि सो विल गेट इगंतस्य नपुंसकस्य इगंतस्य अंगस्य अजादु विभक्तौ परे नुम आगमः भवति नुम इज एन आगम मकार इज एन इट देयरफॉर मिदचोन्त्यात् परः विल अप्लाई एंड विच विल मीन दैट इट विल गो आफ्टर द लास्ट वॉवेल ऑफ द प्रातिपदिका सो हियर यू हैव वारी यू हैव डिराइव्ड वारी नुम आगम विल अप्लाई हियर जस्ट बिफोर द लास्ट वॉवेल सॉरी जस्ट mid achontyat parah after the last vowel so after the last vowel num content is nakara nakara is the content so nakara will be added just after the last vowel so what do you get is sorry o has been replaced by she she content is e so just after the last vowel of the anga this vari varin it will become ikara is the last vowel so you will get this num agama nakara num content is nakara so varin anga will become varin and e pratyay will get varini varini with atkupvamnum yavayapi kim rashabhyam rashabhyam noonah samanapadi so thereby natvam so varini vari varini is the first case dual and second case dual both vari varini in the third case plural jas pratyas not third case plural first case and second case plural what do you get vari plus jas jas is replaced by she by jasya shoho she content of she is e because of lashakattadite tasya lopah then इकोच विभक्तौ नपुंसकस्य नुम आगम वारिन प्लस ई यू गेट वारिन एंड ई वारिनी देन सर्वनाम स्थाने चा संबुद्धो न उपदायः दीर्घः नकारस्य नः दि षष्ठी एकवचन नकारस्य उपदायः दि उपदाय ऑफ दिस नकार फेमिनिन उपदायः दीर्घः सो देयर इज अ दीर्घ आदेश देयरफॉर वारिन विल बिकम वारीन The upada for nakara is this ikara. So this ikara being upada, it will take dirgha, it will become vari, then varini, then atkupnam vyavayapi prashabhyam nona samarapade ityadi will apply. Prashabhyam ityadi. So varini, varini. So vari varini, varini. This is how the forms would go. There is a note here in lagu. न लुमता इति अस्य अनित्यत्वात् पक्षे संबुद्धि निमित्त गुणः हे वारी सो इन संबोधन हे वारी सिंस देयर इज अनित्यत्वम ऑफ न लुमतांगस्य सो देयर बाय हे वारी इज आल्सो वन फॉर्म एंड हे वारी सेकंड फॉर्म इन संबोधन यू विल हैव टू फॉर्म्स लेट्स कीप ऑल दिस Then vari plus ta, third case singular, what happens? Vari, ikochi vibhakto napunsakasyanum. So, ango nastriyam and ikochi vibhakto, both are, so one is 7173, other is 73120. So, they are in vipratishida, both are applicable, but ango na, so angaha, anga is the prior to Panini Maharshi, the name for ta vibhakti, third case singular. So this ang gets a ang ta or which is called as ang earlier. So this ang is replaced by what? Na. Like harina. In hari we have seen this third case singular. So this is also prapta. Astriyam. It is not in strilinga. Therefore angaha na. Na is the adesha prapta. Whereas ikochi vibhaktu iganta anga is there. Vari. And achieve ta is an a pratya so it is ajadi vibhakti which is following and vari is a pratipadika in napunsaka so napunsaka se num is prapta if that happens then vari will become varin and varin plus a, you would get varin plus a. Here what is happening is that there is vipratisheda. Sorry. And vipratishede param karyam na adesha, because 121 is higher number compared to 73, which is a lower number. So param karyam, the later karya will apply by paribhasha sutra vipratishede param karyam, and thereby na adesha by ango nastriyam takes place and you get varina. So you get varina, and then atkupam, here she has written rashabhyam nurana samana pade, she has written the anuvritti also. So varina, fourth case singular, vari plus nye, content is a. Here also what? Vipratisheda between ikochi vibhakto, since vibhakti pratyaya is following, iganta, napunsaka anga, iganta anga, not napunsaka, iganta anga, and gher niti. Napunsaka is there, but it is an anuvritti. Napunsakasya angasya igantasya napunsakasya angasya vibhakto achi ajada vibhakto pare, there is sorry, there is numagama prapta, and gherniti, gherniti is also prapta. Ghi sanya is there for this vari, gherniti, and thereby gherniti gune, guna, guna is there, guna is ordained here. Here there is a guna ordained, is 111 73111, and 7173 is a lower number, this is a higher number. So vipratishede param karyam guna should take place because it is in the para sutra, later sutra, higher numbered sutra, therefore that is prapta. So gher niti iti gune prapte sati, we need a vartika to refute it because there is no guna here. Vari plus nye, vare is not, vare plus nye is, vare plus a is not the form. So vartika is there. Vridhya utva trujvad bhava gunebhya num purva vipratishedena. So vipratishede param karyam is there. So sometimes it is broken as aparam karyam also. So this is a case of vartika where vipratishede param karyam is vipratishede, ekara is preceding. So ing of padata padantad ati, just give a moment. Sorry. So ing of padantad ati can also give you vipratishede aparam karyam padacheda. So that is a consideration given there, and vartika uses that by saying vruddhi autva trujvad bhava and guna, whenever these are the parakarya. So parakarya meaning a higher sutra which is in vipratisheda with another sutra, and that higher sutra, later sutra ordains what? It ordains vruddhi or guna, trujvat bhavaha or autva. So vruddhi, autva, trujvat bhava or guna. Then compared to those, if num is ordained earlier, then num will take precedence. Even if num is not in a later sutra, the earlier sutra num will take precedence by purva vipratisheda. Not para vipratisheda, purva vipratisheda. So aparam karyam will be the padacheda of that sutra. Paribhashika sutra, and thereby although guna is prapta, vartika says that num is to be taken by the puro ipratisheda, thereby num should be applied now. So varin plus ne, not guna but vari plus num will give you varin, and varin plus a will give you varine. Natva will take place as earlier, so varine, varinaha, varino ityadi, it will continue in this manner with the ni, nit pratyas. So gher niti will not apply due to this vartika. Then in shashti bhuvachana vari plus am, what happens? Num achireti nut varinam. So nudagama by hraswanadhyapo nut and vartika, num achirat trujvad bhave bhyo nut puro ipratishedena, thereby there is another Vartika, which gives nut also by Puroi Prati. We have seen this earlier. So num also has Puroi Pratisheda, priority by Puroi Pratisheda, and nut also. So here Hraswanadhyapo nut will take place instead of Ikochi Vivaktav by, although Ikochi Vivaktav is a 7173, a higher sutra compared to 7154 is a lower sutra. So this should have applied by Paramkaryam, Vipratishede Paramkaryam, but Vartika says that Nut will take priority over Guna Ityadi, thereby Varudhruddhi, Autva, Trujvadbhava or Guna. So this fellow Ikochi Vibhaktav is Prapta, but Num Achir, here it says, that was for the earlier sutra. Here the Vartika says the conditions are different. Num achirat trijuvad bhava. So compared to num also, nut will take precedence. So this is ordaining num. If you apply num, what will happen? There will be midachontyat paraha kind of a form. But here, meaning varin plus am, there is a difference. See, although you see varin plus am or vari plus nam sounding similar. So although these sound similar, but then there is a difference among them as to how the other sutras will influence. Therefore, whether the Numagama goes to the Anga or the Nudagama goes to the Pratyaya, there is a difference. So it may sound same during Prakriya at this step, but later steps will influence a different form. So here what happens is that Vari plus Nut plus Aam, Nut is also Nud, Ukara is an it letter as well. So you will get Vari plus Naam, and then Naami Achaha Angasya Dirgha, Dirgha is the Adesha. So after Vari plus Aam becomes Vari plus Naam, Vari will become Vari Dirgha, then Vari Naam by Atkupamnu Vyavayupi, there is a Natva. Then Saptami Ekvachana, Vari plus Ni, here also Num will take place and you will get Varin plus E, Natvam, and you will get Varini. Haladu Harivatu, then wherever there is Haladi Pratya, it will all be like Hari, all forms will be like so. Varibhya Mityadi, Varibhya, all that is absolutely Varishu, there is no issue there, it is like Hari Pullinga. So that is Vari Shabda Ikaranta Napunsaka. Dadi Shabda, what is the difference? This also sounds like Vari Ikaranta, but there is a difference because there are specific Pratipadikas which take Anang Adesha. So it will take an Anang Adesha, thereby a Vidhi Sutra is introduced for a particular set of Pratipadikas in Napunsaka. Asti Dadi Satyaknam Anang Udattaha Akshu Vibhaktishu Tritiyadishu. So Akshu is Saptami Bahuvachana of Ach. So when Ajadi Vibhaktis follow, which Ajadi Vibhaktis, which are after third case? I'm sorry. So Tritiyadishu, after third case, when there is a Pratiparika Asti, Dadi, Sakti or Akshi, then all
recording
of them
in progress.
Sorry. Okay, so just give me a moment, here's something happened here. Okay, yeah. It's my mobile, I was logging into some meeting. Okay, so Akshu Vibhakti Tritiyadishu, when third case onwards, so this means third case to seventh case, all of those cases, Vibhaktis, they should be having Ajadi Pratyaya. Akshu Vibhaktishu will give you Tadadi Vidhi. So Ajadi Vibhaktishu, Tritiyadishu, Ajadi Vibhaktishu, Pare, what will happen? You will get Anang, Anang Adesha, and Udatta is a Swara anyway. So Anang is the Adesha, these are the pratipadika. So dadhi, when you decline, dadhi is there in the sutra itself. So anang will be the adesha, tritiya adishu. So what will happen? Dadhi plus ta. See here dadhi shabda is given later, it is derived earlier, this is how it should be. So dadhi plus su, like the vari shabda, vari varini varini. Similarly dadhi dadhini dadhini, there is no issue with the first and second case. In ta, meaning ta adi, tritiya adi, there is a difference. So you get, in therefore the tritiyadi is derived here. So why me? Sorry. For some reason, mobile is coming on again and again. So what do you have here? Third key, yeah, I went ahead. Yeah, that's why. So tritiya adishu. So tritiya dadi plus ta. Dadi plus ta. So you get anangadesha, ikara will take anangadesha, and it is a nitadesha. Therefore, it will replace only the last letter. So dadi, because multiple letters are there, that would usually see alontyasya and nitcha. So nitcha will tell you that the adesha, even if it is multi-lettered, it will apply only to the last al, which is ikara in dadi. That will be replaced by anang. Anang nyakara is it, akara is also it there. So an will be the adesha, so dadi will become dadhan. Ta content is a, therefore dadhan plus a. This is what you have landed on. Now there is another sutra needed which will take away this akara. This akara goes away by vidhi sutra, which says allopanaha. So allopanaha bhasya angasya, bhasanya ke anga, because third case onwards anyway in all genders is asarnamasthana. Plus what? Ajadi pratyaya is there, therefore yachi bham will apply and bha sanya will be there for ta, meaning for when the ta pratyaya follows, the anga will get bha sanya. So allopa bhasya angasya kim bhavati? Lopaha bhavati. And kasya lopaha bhavati? At. At lopaha bhavati. But here this at, when you split, it will be in six case. Otherwise, ekadesha anvaya will be there with anaha. Anaha is shashti ekvachana sthani. Anaha ataha lopa bhavati. So, ekadesha anvaya should be done. Instead of that, some vrittis say that at is lupta shashti nirdesha. So, at is al. In sandhi, it has become al. But it is a separate pada from lopaha. So, anaha at, meaning anaha ataha lopaha bhavati. So bhasya angasya anaha ataha, the at, meaning at is akara, taparanakarana has been done. So akara of this an, which an? Anang an. Anang is the adesha given earlier. So that anang has an a, content is an, and it has an akara. That akara will undergo lopa when it is in a bha anga. So what do you have here? Thereby you will have, so this at is shashti ekvachana by lupta shashti nirdesha. This is called as lupta shashti nirdesha. So in the sutra, Bhagavan Panini has not used the shashti, he has done lopa of that, but it is in six keys. So at will undergo lopa akara, which is akara, this akara, which is this anaha akara, anaha at, this is that akara, this will undergo lopa, and then you will get dadna. In third case, you will get dadna. So dadna, and so on, dadna, dadne dadnaha, ityadi dadnoho, ityadi forms will be there from third case onwards. Wherever you have an ajadi pratyaya, those are the forms. Okay. then what happens in ni and shi sthana? So there another sutra is read by Panini Maharshi, which says vibhasha as in va. There is an optionality. Anyatarasya, all these mean the same thing. So there is an optionality when ni or shi pratyaya follows. Ni is saptami ekvachana and shi is what? Prathama bahuvachana as well as dvitiya bahuvachana, because jashasho shi. So what is the adesha there? At anaha at lo atna anaha ataha lopaha bhavati basya angasya. This entire sutra, entire earlier sutra is coming as an anurakti to this sutra, making it as an optionality when ni and shi pratyas follow. So therefore he takes this ni as saptami ekvachana. What happens there? So alopa, this lopa is optional. There is an optional lopa, and if it is an optional lopa, you will get dadni or dadani, both form. Dadni if lopa is taken, pakshe dadani. So in saptami ekvachana, and if you look at it, where is this? Sorry, I messed up that she just show she earlier also. So this is not the she is second case and first case dual, not plural, dual. So earlier also I think I made a mistake. I'll just go and correct it. Just show she. Where was it? This should be Hraswa. So she, not she. So I pronounced she, but I wrote as she Sarvanamasthana. So just to show she and she Sarvanamasthana. Whereas now you have dual, not plural. But here vibhasha has been given. Are there two forms here? Dadini, dadni. Have to look this sutra up. Why other forms are not given? She. Chakni Shiva in Parasaptami, just give me one moment. Nishyo Parayuho. Let me look up the sutra in Kashika, because the example does not cover she. Vibhasha Nishyoho. Example is not there. Parataha, maybe it is needed later, that's why it's mentioned. Parata shi shabdecha. Shi shabdecha. Okay, both are all the vrittis also, and tikas there are saying that it is not she which is adesha for jas and shas, but napunsakasya she. But nobody has given the example there. I can't find an example easily. Pakshethi. So there is no example I can find, and it is not given in lagu also. Let's move on. Maybe we have seen it earlier. I am not sure. It just says when she is falling, but that example is not seen here for some reason. So only one dadini, there is only one form there. The next shabda, which is not in lagu, but dvi is taken in neuter. It is not covered in lagu siddhanta kaumudi. Maybe it is there in siddhanta kaumudi. So here dvi plus au, what happens there? Tyadadi naam aha vibhaktau. and napunsakacha onga shi. So this is napunsakacha shi. So this is that shi which has gone in the earlier sutra. So dva plus shi. Here what happens? Dva plus shi. Shi content is e. So tyadadinam a. Tyadadinam aha. A is the adesha. So dvi ikara is replaced by a. And then dva plus au will become dva plus shi. Au is replaced by shi by aunga shi napunsakacha aunga shi. Napunsakacha is the sutra. Aunga shi is the anuvritti. So dva plus e and then ad guna will give you dvi. And it declines only in dvivachana. So prathama and dvitiya dvivachana is dvi. Then dvabhyam dvayoho, that is the form. So dvabhyam thrice and dvayoho twice. This is in Apunsaka, it is not covered in Laghu, form of Dvi. Then 3, what happens? Again, 3 is also not taught in Laghu Siddhanta Kaumudi. 3 plus Jas, 3 plus Shi, Jas is replaced by Shi, Jasya Shoshi. Then Napunsaka, Ikochi Vavakto will give you Numagama, so 3 will become Trin, Trin E, and then Na Upadayaha Dirgaha will give you Trin, Sarvanamasthani Chasambuddho. Nakarasya upadayaha dirgha bhavati. So trin will become trin, trin and e, then natva vatkupam vyayapi will give you trini. So trini, again this will be declining only in plural, so you'll get trini, trini, then tribihi, tribhyaha, then 3 plus am in shashti bhavachana, you'll get hraswanadhyapo, nut, sorry, treyastrayaha first. Ami, so 3 will be replaced by Traya first, and then Nudagama will give you Trayan, Traya plus Nam, then Nami Dirgha, Traya, Nam, then Natvam by Atkupam Vyapi, Traya Nam, Trishu. So these are the forms for 3, not in Laghu, but anyway, since we are going through the book, we will skim through. Then Sudhi, what happens with Sudhi here? Sudhi is derived as an Upapada Tatpurusha. Sushtu dhyayati iti sudhihi in pullinga. Now sudhihi, one who has a good buddhi, that kind of a derivation is also there elsewhere. We have seen this in some other context. But sushtu dhi yasya, that is a bahuri. But here in upapada tatpurusha sushtu dhyayati iti sudhihi, there kvipratyanta shabda is there, upapada tatpurusha. It will make, it's a kartari kvip there, as a karta, one who meditates well, one who focuses well, one who does chinta very well, he is called as sudhi. Now here, what happens is, one who meditates well, this one can be masculine, feminine or neuter. It can be in any of these three genders. That being the case, does the meaning change when the gender changes? It doesn't. So these kind of words where the form may change, but the vritti in the mind, understanding of the word with respect to any gender does not change. For example, balaka and balika, balakaha balika means a child, means a boy child and a girl child. So only gender difference is there, but the meaning of the child does not change with the word. The word has a different form. Balakaha and Balika, they are separate forms, but the understanding of the word, what the word brings as an understanding in the buddhi, that is same. These words are called as Bhashita Pumska. So in the Pullinga also, they have the same meaning in Bhasha. They are called as Bhashita Pumska. So in with that in mind, the sutra is introduced. So you look at it, sudhi, what happens here? Hraswa napunsake pratipadikasya. So hraswa adesha sudhi, ikara ending will become in neuter sudhi, hraswa. Therefore, hraswa will give you sudhi. Then sudhi plus su, when you are declining this in napunsaka, what will happen? Sudhi, samor napunsakat, look. It is an ikara ending. So we have seen in dadi also, we have seen in the vari shabda also, sudhi. So sudhi, sudhini, sudhini, sudhi, sudhini, sudhini. So far, the forms are same like vari or dadi. in third case onwards, we had some change with dadhi, because anangadesha was there, which was not there in vari shabda. In this sudhi kind of derivation, what happens is it is a bhashita pumska shabda, so thereby another sutra is given, which is an atidesha sutra. It extends the akshu vibhaktishu ik napunsakam as an anuvritti to the sutra which is tritiya adishu bhashita pumskam pumvad galavasya. So galavasya matena, as per galava's mata, just a moment here. My medication is over. I have ordered medication. It should come sometime today. Yesterday I forgot to went out, but then I forgot the, I didn't get the medication I wanted, and I forgot the name of the other medication. Sorry. So please bear with my coarse voice and cough. So tritiyadishu bhashita pumskam pumvad galavasya, like lopashakalasya galavasya matena pumvad bhava, meaning it is optional. So pumvad bhava is an optional adesha to the bhashita pumska napunsaka. That napunsaka shabda, which is what? Ikal. So iganta. It should be an iganta, and iganta bhashita pumska. Bhashita pumskam is the adesha. It will take pumvad bhava is the adesha to the bhashita pumska napunsaka. Bhashita pumska means which has in napunsaka also, it may have a different form, but then that pratipadika, even with a different form, has a similar understanding across genders, especially in masculine. So then it will take pumvad bhava, meaning masculine kind of form. That's what it means. When tritiya adishu, when the third case onwards, third case to seventh case, third to seventh case, ajadi pratyas, vibhakti pratyas are following. Thereby what happens? Here, sudhi has taken hraswa, hraswa napunsake pratipare sudhi, then sudhi plus ta, third case singular is tritiya adishu pratya, it is a pratya, ta goes away by chutu, tasya lopa, thereby ajadi pratya vibhakti is following, and napunsaka ikanta, sudhi is iganta, therefore what will happen? Sudhi also has a bhashita pumska, therefore pumvad is the adesha. So bhashita pumska will take pumvad adesha. Now the cases are a little tricky here. If you go through the cases, you will see this pumskam. See, it is napunsakasya undergoes vibhakti parinama to match with bhashita pumskam. Bhashita pumskam is in singular. So bhashita pumskam is considered as pumvad. So it will be considered as pumvad, that is the atidesha, and thereby what will happen is that it will decline it can decline like masculine optionally by what? Tritiya adishu bhashita pumskam pumvad galavasya ityadi sudhiya, then er anekacho sanyoga purvasya yan, which is negated by na bhusidiyo, then yang by achishnu dhatu bhruvam yor yang vangu, thereby yang adesha is given and sudhi becomes sudhiya. Sudhi plus a sudhiya, this is third case singular, which would happen in pullinga also. Pakshe, since it is optional, what will happen? Ango nastri, am na will be the adesha, ta will be replaced by na, and like hari, harina, you will get sudhina. Sorry. So that is sudhi shabda. Again, you see, if you go through this, either you will get iyang adesha or this nakara kind of a thing, and then there are some options. These grey marked are all optional forms. Not all, but most of them, when ni follows, then they are all optional. They have optional forms. मधु शब्द इज एन उकार एंडिंग वर्ड, इट इज अ नपुंसकलिंगा. सो मधु मधुनी मधुनी मधु मधुनी मधुनी दैट इज कॉमन इन संबोधन. देर इज विभाषा. सो गुणा इज वन ऑप्शन एंड दी अदर ऑप्शन इज लोप प्रत्यय लोप. देर फुल गेट हे मधो और हे मधु. सो उकारांत सुलु उपपद तत्पुरुष. सॉरी जस्ट गिव मी अ मोमेंट अगेन. सो सुष्टु लुनाति इति सुलु शस्त्रम. सो वन दैट कट्स वेरी वेल. सो लाइक अ सिकल एक्स स्वॉर्ड एटसेट्रा. इट्स अ क्विबंत उपपद तत्पुरुष कर्तरी क्विब. सो सुलु इज दी डेरिवेशन देर सुलु एंड देन इट्स अ कृदंत शब्द देर फोर कृतंत समास अश्चर्मिकट प्रातिपदिक इन नपुंसक. नाउ व्हाट हैपेंस इज दैट again here also it is taking pumvat and therefore yana adesha by osupi ityadi and the derivation is given. You can go through as to in nisthana and ta onwards. Actually tritiya adisho there are some places where you get dual forms here also. So grayed out, you see grayed out parts are having dual forms. Sorry, so grayed out parts are having tritiya adisho there. Tritiyadishu and here what is the condition there? The condition earlier was what? Ik. Ik. And Ajadi. So Ik is fulfilled by the Pratiparika. Ajadi Pratyaya is there only when there is a Bhastana there. So therefore Tritiyadishu there is a Bhastana also. When Ajadi Pratyaya, basically Ajadi Pratyaya is following. So in Ajadi Pratyas are, you will have two forms. इयंग आदेश और नॉन इयंग आदेश फॉर्म. सो ना इत्यादि आदेश जुड़ोगे और नी नी स्थान. सो देर फोर वी गेट टू फॉर्म्स. दोज आर दी ग्रेड आउट. हियर वॉट इज हैपनिंग हियर ऑल्सो सुलू ऑल्सो हैज पुंवत भावा. देर फोर टू फॉर्म्स तृतीयादिशु अजादी ओनली इन अजादी तृतीयादिशु यूल हैव अजादी प्रत्यय इज देर देन यूल गेट टू फॉर्म्स. फर्दर वॉट धातु शब्द. सो रुकारांत रुकारांत न्यूटर व्हाट हैपेंस. सो धातु शब्द धातु धातु प्लस सु. सो समोर नपुंसकात लुक. सो देर इज अ लुक. सो धातु देन औ गेट्स अ शी आदेश वै नपुंसकाश्च औंग शी लशको तद्दी तस्य लोप विल गिव यू ई प्रत्यय इज ई धातु प्लस ई. देर इज नुमागम बाई इकोची विभक्तो धातृन देन धातृणी नत्वम बाय वार्तिका टू प्रशाभ्याम नोणः समान पदे दि नकार विच इज इमीडिएटली फॉलोइंग ऋकार विल ऑल्सो रुवर्णा नस्य नत्वम वाच्यम नत्व बाय वार्तिका. सो धातृणी धातृ धातृणी धात्रीणी. सो थर्ड फॉर्म इज इन प्लूरल इज धातृ प्लस जस जस शोषी देन लशको तद्दीते तस्लोप ई इकोचि विभक्तो नुम नकार मिदचोन्त्यत्परा विल गिव धातृन धातृन प्लस ई धातृनी सर्वनाम स्थानी चा संबोधो दीर्घ नो उपदाय. सो नकार से उपदाय दीर्घ बाय वॉट सर्वनाम स्थाने च असंबुद्धौ. सर्वनाम स्थाने yeah because jasa that is not added. So here it is jasa shoshi then you have to add shi sarvanam sthan sarvanam sthanam and thereby what will happen dhatrun plus e you will get dirgha to the upada of nakara. So therefore dhatrun and you will get dhatruni by vartika टू रशाभ्याम गुण सवार पदे विच इज रोवर्णात्नस्य नत्वम वाच्यम. सो यू गॉट धातृ धातृणी धातृणी इन फर्स्ट टू केसेस. संबोधन हे धाता हे धातृ देयर इज एन ऑप्शन because su is not sarvanamasthana. Sarva, not sarvasthana, sarvanamasthana. Since it is not a sarvanamasthana in neuter, therefore what? Rutongi sarvanamasthana does not take place. Then what will happen? Instead, hraswasya gunaha take place in sambuddhi. So we will get he. Rukara guna is akara, and then uran rapara will give dhatar. So hraswasya gunaha, then uran rapara dhatar, then visarga will give you. I don't think 66 rutva is not valid, visarga is valid, visarjaniya. So dhataha, because repa is already there. I don't think 8 to 6 is rutva, because repa is by urandrapara. I think here it has to be urandrapara. So ru is replaced by a gunaha rasvasya guna, therefore urandrapara will apply. Instead of this you have to apply urandrapara here. Urandraparaha here itself along with guna it will apply, and then urandrapara, and then visarga, by you will get he dhataha if optionally. So therefore it will be lopa will take place of the pratyaya, you will get he dhatru, or there will be guna and then visarga. So third case onwards, bhashita bhumska, this is also dharana poshaneyo dhatu dudanj dharana poshaneyo, it has the same meaning. The nourisher dhatruda is a nourisher in without the form being the same across genders, the meaning is still the same, therefore it is a bhashita pumska, and pumvat bhava is optional tritiya adishu, therefore there will be two forms. So you will see in neuter you will have dhatru plus, so if you directly go to the table you will see gray marked out where you will have options, optional form. Now okaranta pradyo in neuter, prakrishta dyohu yasya yasmin tat pradyu dinam. So which has a day with a high luster or high shining day, that will be called as pradyo. So this pradyo in any gender will have a similar meaning. So bhashita pumska here, pradyo is bhashita pumska, however it is not ig ending, ik is not at the end, and in tritiya dishu bhashita pumskam pumad galasya has an ik as a anuvritti, but this is not ig ending, it is okara ending. Now what will happen? This does not apply, bhashita pumska sutra optionally does not apply, but before you decline this word what has to be done is hraswo napunsake pratipadikasya will apply. What is the okara hraswa? Okara is dirgha, okara and aukara have no hraswa at all. So how will it take hraswa adesha? For that another sutra is needed, and thereby niyamana sutra. Niyama sutra is there. Echa ik hraswa adeshe. Sutra says echa ik hraswa adeshe. Ik is the hraswa adesha for h. So h will take ik adesha. That is a hraswa. Whenever hraswa adesha is given, then hraswa adesha sati, when there is hraswa adesha, then h will take ik. So ekara will take ikara, okara will take ekara, ikara, okara and okara do not have hraswas, but hraswa is given in napunsaka, therefore all these age ending napunsaka pratipedikas will take ik. So a and o will take A and I will take ikara, O and O will take ukara adesha. That is the idea. Thereby what has happened? O will take ukara adesha by hraswa napunsake pratipadikasya and echa ikhraswa adesha. And of course sthane antarattama will decide as to okara will have ukara adesha. So pradyo will become pradyu. So in napunsaka pradyo will become pradyu, pradyu plus su in first case singular, so more napunsaka at look, this will go away, you get pradyu. So pradyu will declare as pradyu, pradyu, pradyuni, pradyuni. So everything else is similar. So Pradyu, Pradyuni, Pradyuni. This is how the declension will be. And since there is no dual form, it will have a singular form. There is no Pumvat Bhava. Although Pumvat Bhava is there, it is not Iganta. Sorry. Therefore, it will decline like Madhu. Aikaranta. Aikaranta Prarai is there. Again, what will happen? Prarai Prakrushta Rayasya or Yasmin Tat Prari Kulam. So, Ra is Dhana. So, that Kula, that family which has a lot of wealth. So, wealthy family is called as Prarai. In Napunsaka Prarai, it will take Hraswa Adesha. So, Aikara, Hraswa is Ikara Ik. So, Echaha Ik, Hraswa Adeshe. So, Hraswa Napunsake Pratiparikasya will give you Hraswa Adesha, and Hraswa for I is Ik, which is Ikara. By Sthaniyantartamaha, after the Parivashika Sutra, Echa Hraswadeshe, Sthaniyantartama will give you Ikara. So, Prarai will become Prari. Now, this in Napunsaka. So, Prarai is Prari, wealthy family, plus Su. When you decline, what will you get? Look, Samur Napunsakat, look, Prari. Then, Prarini, Prarini. Everything else is similar. There is Numa Agama, and then it will decline just like any other napunsaka which is not akara ending, akara or akara ending. So ig ending will have similar declension. Additional sutra is there which will make it hraswanta. Sorry. In ta what will happen? Ango nastriyam. So it is not stri napunsaka. Therefore prariplashta will be prariplashta is prariplashta, then prari plus na. Ta will be replaced by na pratyaya by angona striyam gehe, then prarina by natvam atku pangu yahapi. In bhyam, prari plus bhyam, what happens? Rayo hali. Rayo hali, since this ri is actually ra dhatu, rai, so there is a ra, so rayo hali, what will happen? Hali avibhaktav. So akara is the adesha. Ikara will take akara adesha, then you get prarabhyam. This sutra we have seen earlier. When we decline rai shabda. So rabhyam ityadi. So prarabhyam. Here also prarabhyam. Then in shashti bhavachana, harsunadhyaponut, nami dirgha, atkupvangum vyayapi, natvam, so you get prarinam. And so on is the declension for Aikar ending. Just give me one moment. Yeah, we are at the end, so I'll just finish this last word. So we'll have finish the second book. So Sunau, Aukar ending. So Shobana Nauhu, Yasya, Yasmin Tat Sunu Kulam. Again, Kula here. Sunau Kula. So Sunau Aukara is replaced by Ukara by Hraswa Napunsake Pratiparikasya. So you got Sunu. Now Sunu will decline like what? Sunu, like Ukara ending, neuter. So look, Sunu, ityadi. So you'll get Sunu, Sununi, Sununi, Sunu, Sununi, Sununi. Only thing is that Sambodhana in all these cases has an option. Just like in Dadi also we saw, you'll have options, He Dadi or He Dade. Similarly, He Suno, He Sune. So Guna or Pakshe, Pratyelopa in Sambuddhi. Everything else is similar to Madhu in Ukara ending Napunsaka. So this finishes the Iti Ajanta Napunsaka Linga. So Napunsaka Ajanta is over. Now we look at Halanta Pullinga Ityadi in the next part with the third book. Nutavasane Nataraja Rajo Nana Dhadakkano Panchavaram उद्धरतु कामस सनकादि सिद्धानि तद्विमर्शे शिवसूत्र जालम. नमस्ते धन्यवाद. सॉरी फॉर द कफ. आई एम हैविंग अ सोर थ्रोट व्हिच हैज एग्रेवेटेड फर्दर. आई कैंसल द मॉर्निंग क्लासेस बट आई डिडंट वांट टू कैंसल दिस. वी हैव टेकन सो मेनी कैंसलेशंस. टुमारो ऑनवर्ड्स आई एम शिफ्टिंग टू माय ब्रदर्स प्लेस एंड आई वुड